بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters in Islam, one of the main reasons for why many people feel like that they lost their Ramadan, or they didn't take advantage of their Ramadan, or they didn't make the most of Ramadan, one of the main reasons for this is because they did not prepare before Ramadan. That's true. That's what it comes down to. They did not prepare before Ramadan. And so we want to avoid this problem for this year. And to avoid it, you must prepare. And we are now in the best position to prepare for Ramadan. You all know that the companions, radiallahu anhum, they would ask Allah Azza wa Jal to allow them to reach Ramadan and witness Ramadan 6 months before Ramadan. That's a form of preparation. This is a form of preparation. For we need to prepare. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he said that if a person was to pray every single night of the year, he will definitely earn the reward of Laylatul Qadr. That makes sense, because if you're praying every single night of the year, then you're bound to catch Laylatul Qadr. So the idea is Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu in this hadith is teaching us that preparation is important. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu knows that Laylatul Qadr is in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And he knows it's in the last odd nights of the last 10 nights. He knows this. But he's giving us a broad understanding that if your preparation is so good that you're praying every single night of the year, then don't worry, you will definitely catch the reward of Laylatul Qadr. Allahu Akbar. And it's so true. How many of us don't pray the night prayer? And when Ramadan comes in, we pray Salat al-Taraweeh. And then when the last 10 nights come, that's the only time we want to stay awake the entire night or most part of the night to pray. And how many times, and this is so true, how many times, how many Ramadans, you've accidentally slept through the 21st night. Or you accidentally slept through the 23rd night, or the 25th night, or the 27th night, or the 29th night. How many times has it happened? This is because there was no preparation for Ramadan. There was no preparation for the last 10 nights. There was no preparation. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, avoid this feeling that you will have after Ramadan and saying, I didn't get the most of my Ramadan. I lost my Ramadan. I feel like I wasted it. Avoid all this by preparing. The one who prepares, bi-idhnillah, he'll feel satisfied after Ramadan. His iman will be charged and nurtured, bi-idhnillah, to carry on with him until he meets the next Ramadan. Was-salaf, rahimahumullah, they used to say that Shahru Rajab, which is the month we're in now, is Shahru al-Badr. It is the month in where we plant our seeds. And the next month, which is Sha'ban, is the month of As-Suqya. It's the month in which we water the seeds. And so you know this process of burying seeds into the earth and then watering the seed. What's that? That's preparation. This is preparing. This is how you prepare a tree in order for it to grow. So this is preparation. What As-Salaf rahimahumullah were saying, that the month of Rajab and Sha'ban are months of preparation. This is where you put serious work, hard work and effort. And then they said Ramadan is the month in which we harvest the fruit. This is the month in which the fruits are now ripened and they're perfect to harvest and eat. And when you eat fruit, what happens? You enjoy the experience. Even Ramadan is not the month in which you prepare. This happens way before. Ramadan is the month in which now you're enjoying this worship. You're enjoying reciting the Quran. You're enjoying praying. You're enjoying the fasting because you've been used to it. Now for 2 months, you've been on a trend and on a routine and on a specific lifestyle, so that when Ramadan enters, you sit back, you relax, and you just continue that which you used to do of preparation in this month of Rajab and Sha'ban. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, don't waste this Ramadan. Allahu A'lam, it could be your last Ramadan. It could be our last Ramadan. We don't even know if we'll get there or not. But have the correct intention from now. Use these 2 months, whatever we have of them, in preparation for Ramadan. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He give us the ability that we worship Him the way He deserves to be worshipped. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive us and to allow us to reach Ramadan, to witness Ramadan, and to make Ramadan a source of blessing in our life. Wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.